Are you studying for GED Math? Do you need to know how to do questions with square roots and squares for your test? Well, that's what I'm going to teach you in this video. Hi, this is Parker here from Test Prep Champions to teach you how to pass the GED fast. And you can get started by clicking subscribe down below.
So let's start by understanding how to find the square of a number. So whenever you see a question like this, you can read this as either 5 squared or 5 raised to the second power, two different ways to say the same thing here. And we see that the bigger number is our base. So 5 is our base, and this little number that's hanging out up top here is what we call the exponent here. And that exponent tells you how many times the number 5 is going to appear in multiplication. So since it's a 2, we know that 5 is going to appear in the multiplication 2 times. So 5 squared is equal to 5 times 5. Now, a common mistake would be to think that 5 squared is equal to 5 times 2, and that's incorrect. So 5 squared does not equal 5 times 2. All right, so I'm going to cross out this equal sign so we know that this whole thing is incorrect, but that's a common mistake students make. So understand that 5 raised to the second power means that you multiply 5 by itself, so that way you end up with 2 5s in your work here. And 5 times 5 is going to equal 25, and that is the correct answer here.
So that's how we do squares, but what about square roots?
We're going to use 25 as an example, and we want to find the square root. So the first thing to understand is that this symbol here, this bracket that's surrounding the 25, is what we call a square root symbol, and that tells us to take the square root. So to find the square root of any number, just note that the square root is some number that's equal to the number in the brackets when it's multiplied by itself. So what we do here is we want to think about when we did 5 squared, right? We knew that 5 squared equals 25. So from this, we know that 5 multiplied by itself is going to be 25, and that's actually going to be the square root. So if we take that square root of 25, it gets us back to 5. So again, to find the square root, just note that the square root is a number that's equal to the number in the bracket when it's multiplied by itself. So right now you might be wondering how you're supposed to remember how to find the square roots. So to make life simple, I've given you this list of some common square roots. Now you can just memorize these, add them to your notes, or just tuck these away in the back of your head, but these are all good to know because they're going to come up a lot. And this list comes right out of my GED Math Champions Guide. You can get that down below. I'll put a link in the description.
Just a heads up, these next two examples are really, really, really important to understand.
So what if on your test you get an example like this? The square root of 20 equals blank, and you have to solve it without a calculator. Well, how in the world are you supposed to do this? Well, it's actually not that hard if we break it down here. So what we want to do is we want to think of numbers that will multiply together to give us 20. So let's think of pairs here. So I know that 20 times 1 is going to give us 20, so we'll use 20 and 1. And I also know that 10 and 2 will multiply together to give us 20. Can you think of any other pairs here? What about 4 and 5? Well, 4 and 5 multiply together to give us 20. So what you want to do here is just think of numbers that will multiply together to give you the number here underneath the square root symbol. And then once you've done that, you want to think about your list of common square roots, and you want to look for numbers that are on the list here that have square roots that are common. So what about this square root of 4 here? So the square root of 4 is 2, so we're going to use this pair here. And the trick is that you can rewrite the square root of 20 as the square root of 4 times 5. And again, the reason that we can do that is because 4 times 5 equals 20. So what I've just done is I've taken the square root of 20 and I rewrote it as the square root of 4 times 5. And now we can rewrite this again as the square root of 4 times the square root of 5. And now here's where I'm going with this. So remember that the square root of 4 is on our list of common square roots. It's just 2. So we can actually rewrite this again as 2 square root of 5. And that's actually going to be the answer. So without a calculator, this is as far as you can go. But the answer is 2 square root of 5. So I got that because when I took the square root of 4 here, we just got that 2. So we'll leave that 2 on the outside. And since 5 is not on our list of common square roots, we just leave it as the square root of 5.
One of the types of problems on GED Math that's been giving test takers the most trouble lately is this exact example that I'm going to show you next.
If you really want to see if you're understanding this, pause the video and try this. X squared equals 64. What's the value of x? So hopefully you had a chance to try that, but if not, that's okay too. Let's go over this. We've got x squared equals 64. We need to find the value of that x. So the principle here is that if you ever have a base squared and you take the square root of that base squared, it just gives you the base. So here's what I mean. So let's say that we have 5 squared. And if we take the square root of 5 squared, it just gives us the base. It just gives us 5. So using that principle here, we're just going to solve by taking the square root of x squared. That's going to give us x. And in math, whatever you do to one side of an equation, you also do it to the other so that they balance out. So let's take the square root of x squared. And when we do that, we've also got to take the square root of the 64 here. Now, the square root of x squared just gives us the base, so it just gives us x. And the square root of 64, you might remember from our list of common square roots, that is 8. So the correct answer here is 8. Now, an incorrect way to do this would be to try to do 64 times 64. So some students would get a question like this, x squared equals 64, and they'd try to solve it for x by squaring the 64. So they would do 64 times 64, and they would get a really, really big number here, like 4,096, right? But that's actually incorrect. So that's not what you want to do here, because to get that value of x, you have to remember that starting out here at the very beginning of this equation, what we had at the very beginning of the equation was just x squared equals 64, and we need to get that x. So we've got to get rid of that square, and we do that by taking the square root.
Now that you know where you're at with square roots, your next step is to see where you're at with the algebra with my algebra video lesson here. And also see where you're at by taking a GED Math practice test. I'll walk you through it here with this video. Thanks for watching. This is Parker from Test Prep Champions here to help you pass the GED fast. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that thumbs up button. Thank you.